China's former one-child policy and other state-sanctioned population control policies have created a legacy of gender imbalance that drives the demand for brokered marriages between Chinese men and women from around the world. Now, as we note in the Trafficking in Persons report that comes out every year in June, every year, deceptive and coercive brokers transport thousands of women and girls and men from Southeast Asia, Africa, all the way to China, where traffickers subject them to sex trafficking, sexual assault, forced childbearing, and forced labor in domestic service under false pretenses of marriage to local men.
This bride trafficking into China and this kidnapping and coercion of women into the sex trade, essentially, through marriage. And it should really erase any question about why the United States is so committed to working on these issues and why we have taken such a strong stand on the issue of trafficking of women and girls and the need to support and assist them.
The Chinese Communist Party knows it can never match our innovation. A state-owned enterprise, its authoritarian regime, it is a government-centric focus. That's why it sends 400,000 students a year to the United States of America to study. 400,000 students a year studying in our universities come from one country. It is no accident. Much of the high-end industrial base inside of China is based on stolen technology or technology purchased from other nations. It's not homegrown. Beijing doesn't want Chinese researchers to stay here in the United States. The CCP doesn't just target Chinese nationals. They want to influence American students as well. Professors and administrators too. We cannot allow this tyrannical regime to steal our stuff, to build their military might and brainwash our people, or buy off our institutions to help them cover up these activities.
We literally are on track to distribute tens of millions of doses of the coronavirus vaccine before the end of this month. We're about to make history. And together, we're going to continue to save lives across this country. With the approval of first coronavirus vaccine, we believe is likely within days. As I said, we are one step closer to the day that, as a people, we will put this pandemic in the past. And as the president said from this very podium today, that America will continue to do our part to help families and peoples around the world.